Welcome. When I ask my first year students, what does this integral mean? They usually answer, it's an area. Would this be your answer too? Then you should watch this video. It is true that in some cases, the number that you get when you evaluate an integral represents an area. Remember, for example, the function in the previous video. The Riemann sum represents the total area of a number of rectangles. If you increase the number of rectangles, they will cover the region between the graph and the horizontal axis more accurately. In the limit, the region is exactly covered. In this case, the area of the region is, in fact by definition, equal to the limit of the Riemann sum. And this limit is precisely the integral of the function over the interval. So in this case, the integral is an area. But in general, you have to be careful. Problems arise when the function becomes negative at certain points. What's the interpretation then? Let us first look at the Riemann sum. At points where the function is negative, the corresponding terms in the Riemann sum will also be negative. Therefore, the Riemann sum represents the total area of the rectangles above the axis minus the total area of the rectangles below the axis. Now take the limit to obtain the integral. The graph, the horizontal axis, and the lines x equal to a and x equal to b enclose a region, and the integral represents the total area b of the part above the horizontal axis minus the area a of the part below the axis. It is referred to as the signed area of the region. You may wonder what the use of this signed area is. Indeed, if you want to paint the region, it's of no use. To know how much paint you need, you would have to know the actual area, in this case A plus B. But think again of energy consumption. We have seen that it is equal to the integral of the power as function of time. How can power consumption become negative? Well, for example, if you live in a modern house with solar panels on the roof, on a sunny day, the solar panels may produce more power than you use at that moment. The amount of power you deliver back to the electricity network is equal to the total area between the negative part of the graph and the horizontal axis. And to determine your effective power consumption, you have to subtract this from the area between the positive part of the graph and the horizontal axis. That is, your total energy consumption is equal to the signed area of the region enclosed by the graph and the interval from A to B on the horizontal axis. In fact, it is the aim of the Prêt-à-Loger project that we mentioned in the context video to get this number to zero. So, let me return to the original question. What does this integral mean? The correct answer is, it is the signed area of the region enclosed by the graph, the horizontal axis, and the lines x equal to a and x equal to b. Please remember.